The U.S. Grains Council recently concluded a historic technology transfer mission to Morocco. The trip brought seven members from India's largest dairy cooperative, Gujarat Cooperative Milk Marketing Federation, or GCMMF, to meet with COPAG, one of the world's leading innovators in social transformation funded by dairy farming. India is proudly home to the world's largest dairy production, and GCMMF is owner of Asia's largest dairy brand, Amul. Amul milk pouches and butter can be seen on store shelves throughout the entire world, including the U.S. The council, along with special financial contribution from the Kansas Corn Commission, brought the team to Morocco to learn about a heifer conditioning project the council helped get off the ground over a decade ago. The facility, which has the capacity for around 16,000 head, served as a model for replication that GCMMF can take home to India with them. Despite being the largest dairy producers on the planet, India is plagued with poor heifer calf nutrition. Too often, Indian farmers see heifer calves as non-revenue generating drags rather than financial opportunities that require proper nutritional investment. Studies have shown that proper nutrition when a calf is young can have major implications when the cow is at peak milk production. Aside from heifer calf conditioning, participants also learned how milk is collected from smallholder farmers on the village level and then ultimately processed in state-of-the-art facilities to be delivered throughout the country. Of course, proper nutrition was a key component of the technology exchange mission, as a cow's performance and what she eats has a direct correlation. Previously unknown feed ingredients in India like corn silage and DDGs took center stage. In the U.S., these two feed ingredients are virtually synonymous with dairy production. However, in Gujarat, their usage is limited. Nevertheless, the primary focus was to showcase the joint beef feedlot and heifer conditioning facility that the council helped build. The facility represents the council's signature project in Morocco and today officially marked its graduation. The council wishes to help India get a similar model established to help build economies of scale, increase farmer efficiency, and improve the overall genetic makeup of the Indian dairy industry. On the sidelines, I was able to catch up with some participants of the team and download their thoughts and observations and get their opinions of how all the parties can move forward. Let's take a look. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Kevin Ripke with the U.S. Grains Council. I'm the regional director based in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. My territory is South and Southeast Asia, as well as Oceania. However, today we come to you from the feedlot project owned by COPAG in Morocco. Now, we come to you today from Morocco because this is a textbook U.S. Grains Council project. Today, we're actually graduating the project and using it as a global model for our friends throughout the world. Today, I have with us the Gujarat Cooperative Milk Marketing Federation. They're the owners of the Amul milk brand. The Amul milk brand is the most valuable milk brand in all of Asia. It's the largest dairy cooperative in India. India is the largest dairy producing country in the entire world. Today I have with us Mr. Rathod of GCMMF. Mr. Rathod, I'd like to ask you what your impressions and what your initial reactions were to the trip as a whole.
When we first heard that we are going to Morocco and U.S. Grain Council has planned a trip for us at the Morocco, we were surprised that most of the developed countries are, say, either US or we can go to Netherlands or some European country, and why Morocco? Then our US Grain Council representative, Mr. Sachdev, and yourself has explained that Morocco is having a good calf rearing project. So we thought that we are also doing the calf rearing. So what's new would be there to learn. But still, we thought, okay, when US Grain Council is saying that something great is there, let us go and see. And let me tell you that it's worth visiting. We have come here and we have seen this calf rearing project. and we have never seen such a project on any large scale anywhere. In India also, we do not have any such project which is on such a large scale, well planned, and having say around 8,000 cars. And for us, seeing this project is seeing is a believing, and let me tell you, believing leads to implementation. So we are looking for it that okay, we may in future implement such project.
Very good. So what are the next steps that you think you might actually take away, or what are your takeaways from the trip and this project, the heifer conditioning project that you witnessed, and what can possibly be done?
First of all, we have learned many new things here, and many new things about calf rearing concept itself. We know the scientific way, but our calf rearing is somewhat different than what we have learned here with statistical figures and facts. So we are going to implement our basic learning and in our extension programs, which we give to each and every farmer, whatever we have learned new. So it will reach to entire Gujarat, that we can assure. Other thing regarding having a calf rearing project, we'll put up this entire details to our management. We'll try to modify this concept little bit to our Indian condition, because condition somewhat is little bit different than the Morocco here. Here you are having 8 inch of rain. Our rain condition is somewhat different. Our southern Gujarat have much more rain, northern Gujarat have little rains. So we'll modify this and put up a project to our management and see how this can be further taken up to develop our farmers.
Very interesting. Thank you very much. And on behalf of the Grains Council, thank you so much to you and your compatriots for joining us here in Morocco.
Thank you.
To my left is Mr. Terry Vindeska. Mr. Vindeska is a past chairman of the U.S. Grains Council. He's also a current board member of the Kansas Corn Commission. Kansas Corn Commission, we are happy to say, is one of the founding partners on this project, and we're very thankful for the excitement and the enthusiasm that Kansas Corn Commission has instilled in the project. Terry, I'd like to ask you the same questions. What are your thoughts and impressions of the trip thus far, and the project as a whole?
Kevin, my first thought is it's always wonderful to visit this incredible facility in Morocco. It's first class, state of the art, top quality. One of the best in the world. Second impression is it's amazing, and I feel very proud that Kansas Corn could be one of the founding sponsors for this program, sharing some of this information with our friends from India, knowing that we have the opportunity to move forward together and continue to partner with the Grains Council.
That's great. Ladies and gentlemen, from here in Morocco, I encourage you to follow U.S. Grains Council on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. If you're interested in this project or learning more about it or getting more involved, please reach out to the U.S. Grains Council at grains.org. From Morocco, signing off, I'm Kevin Ripke. Thank you very much.